sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong end when he coming to stop. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking block of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Look, I played the game, I missed the shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not, for lexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not, my not, paralyzed the set, but I've been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the neck of the serpent, determined the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my gush. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
The NFL on EA Sports brings us to North Carolina and Bank of America Stadium here in Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. Kicker Robbie Gould set to get us started. And off we go from uptown Charlotte. Fields this way up at the 17. And able to get this out to the 25. They fake the give. Newton. That's complete out right to the tight end, Trimble. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. There's Trimble, the tight end. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Carolina. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years with the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
We've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities, and we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big gain.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
Here's a run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard. Second and 11. Lance a handoff here to Mostert. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
Steps away. This one caught by Kittle, pushing his way through. And they do finally get him at the 12. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. On first and 10, it's Mostert. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They'll run right side with Mostert. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled him with the inside run.
They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And it'll be a turnover on downs. From the end zone, Newton. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. To throw again on second down, Newton. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner, forget starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10-yard line in, a lot of teams call it that because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
Here's Mostert. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. Second and goal from inside the 5. Now Lance. This is caught. Touchdown 49ers. Raheem Mostert from 4 yards out. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Gold with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Flushed out right. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And he'll be taken down inside Carolina's 15. A big play there for the Niners.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Getting this out to the flat, Mostert.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Now a give to Mostert running right. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Raheem Mostert with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down. Cam's throw complete there to Thomas. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Now a play fake, and it's Newton. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. They snap it to Newton. And this is caught. He hits Moore. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Again, Newton. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he'll get nothing out of that one. So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And that'll make it second and 10. That caught by Trimble. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 17-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Quick slant, caught by Moore. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as he'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. 2 yards left on second down from the 9. Newton gonna hand it off to McCaffrey. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey in the final seconds of the first half. And the Panthers have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And the lead is now 21-14. So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. A nice start to the drive, picking up 12 yards there and a very quick first down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. This is Mostert. Breaks through the contact. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Each team making their final preparations for this second half. We're about ready, too, as we'll send you back up to Charlotte and rejoin Brandon and Charles at Bank of America Stadium.
Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. The 49ers going to have the football and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
His second catch, this one not quite as dynamic as his first, and it's second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two, wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Deebo Samuel, 50 yards. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And now this is right in Kyle Shanahan's wheelhouse. He'll go for two here. They'll try and throw for it. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Niners are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
I got kicked out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. With the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. To the air again, Newton. They'll roll him out right. And he's got his big tight end here.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. So their task a little bit more difficult now, second and 13 that they're walking up on. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked up by Ambry Thomas. And he'll get this back across the midfield stripe and down to the 47-yard line. So they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first down, it's Mitchell. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Faking the give to Mostert. Now Lance. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there. And it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release. And they did force the incomplete pass.
An incomplete pass on that last play. And that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Rush coming. And he's taken down. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. And they'll go for it. Lance. This will be caught. It's Samuel. Touchdown! Deebo Samuel. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And once again, the 49ers are back out in front.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
That three touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And look at this. Cam Newton intercepted a third time. Picked up by Ambry Thomas. He got outside the pocket there trying to improvise, and he was calling for the ball downfield, but still the interception.
I think what happened, he did call for the ball thinking that he was open, but I think the quarterback spotted him too late, and that margin that he had on the defenders, that got eaten up, and they came up with the interception.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. On the handoff, this is Mostert. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. On play action, Lance. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
The kick by Gould is good, and that will make this a 9-point lead. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. A tougher task for them now. That turnover on their last possession led to the field goal. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
Flush to his right. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time, Newton, fourth down. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Back to throw, Newton. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
You turn on your mic for that bullshit? Nigga, come on.
Seen score. Neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along, but if you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. A big play there for the Niners. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Off of play action, here's Lance. Well, same target, same result. It's Kittle. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10. And mark him at the 5. And now a timeout taken here defensively with 2:07 remaining. So they'll also have the stop coming up at the 2-minute. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco
That was
touchdown.
Cute. Good job, Doc.
Raheem Mostert, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. Now the 49ers electing to leave the offense out there and go for two. They'll try and run it up the middle. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. Only had a couple of yards to gain there on the 2-point conversion, and they were able to do it.
And how many teams shy away from running the football on the 2-point conversion? They treat 2 yards as if it were 20. If you're a good team running the ball, go to your strength. Go ahead and push it into the end zone.
Yeah, they did. It worked. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. Oh, and this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, 73 yards. And the Panthers have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
You've got to understand situational football because they're playing with the lead here late in the ball game. So the back defender has got to be as deep as the deepest receiver. Keep everything in front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they had the three-score lead. Now it's down to two, but three-score lead here late that they wouldn't give up a big pass play like that, but they did. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. 20, 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Deebo Samuel, 78 yards. And the 49ers use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie, but he's playing like fourth quarter, and the QBing is easy. How about this guy? Youngster, not worried about anything, just cutting it loose and having fun.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Cam to throw. Flushed out right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Throwing is Newton. He's going to air one out for Anderson. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute. Well, they knew a lot of steps had to happen here. They got step one, the touchdown. You need a two-point conversion here, don't you?
You do, and as you continue to look ahead, if you're able to get that, somehow get the ball back and get another score, they have to go for two again. That's why teams are practicing multiple two-point plays.
We saw that. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jason Verrett. And the Panthers are right back in this football game. So two scores down. Time definitely not an ally. But here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on it. A miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. That one looks like he'll throw here. This one caught by Kittle. Touchdown! George Kittle, 42 yards. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Gold with the extra point, and that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And they're going to start this drive at pretty...